Yeah, you know, and
Yes. Next up, we
got the man himself, I'm gonna meet you guys, so really, really open your ears. I'm gonna try to open up your ears for everybody in this room. But this man needs an ear. This man needs an undivided attention. He goes by the name of Young Racist. I want y'all to give y'all a little bit of attention. You got some love in the light.
All right, y'all, I'm coming up there.
You're coming up.
How everybody doing?
All right.
Really great. It's a pleasure to have everybody out. Man, everybody, this is exactly what the network is supposed to look like. This is exactly what we're supposed to do. Typically, the quote-unquote African-American network event that I've been to and I've seen, I know you've seen a lot, even the previous ones, one of the biggest problems I've seen is that we're not actually networking. You know, you don't want to be too cool, don't want to, you know, or don't really want to break the ice and stuff like that, but we got to break that bad habit. You know, we need to get to understand, know, you know, our surroundings, the people around us, get to know what their core values are, how we can share values together to get to a higher place. You know, everybody here has a specialty, a skill, a resource, something that we share and bring it brought to a higher level. Me personally, I don't have to speak to you. Me personally, I'm into a lot of things, me and my brothers here. You can call me a human rights activist. You know, I'm here trying to figure out the biggest issues we have with everybody here in the so-called America, you know, the country called America, and trying to bring these things to a screeching halt, you know, involving child custody, child support, driver's license, just status correction altogether. You know, how we make money, credit, personal credit, business credit. You know, how we circulate money amongst ourselves and throughout the community. You know, we know how to utilize our resources to really give back, you know, to the people so we can leave legacies for our families and not just kind of and say we made it because we had a nice car and a nice house and that's it. That's not the purpose of us being here. And outside of your title, what are you giving back to the people? So that's my whole objective. You know, I want to cut to the core of that issue with every last person. You know, so I'm here to share what I've been through, what I know. Y'all want more, I'll pass out my business card to everybody, and we'll take it from there.
I just want to touch on one thing. You know, you talk about your stats. Your stats in this world as well as
Officer! status he's referring to, we call diplomat status. Diplomat, this is the embassy that you got in the air right now. I'm not a possible cop on that. But it's a few diplomats in here. And we're here to have a place in the venue for you guys to reach out to.
Right. So you want me to go in depth? So if I'm a bill collector and I call trying to retrieve a mouth that you owe, what happens?
Well, this is the thing. That has nothing to do with status. Right. You understand? Like, this thing, every problem we deal with in this particular world at this time, you somehow, some way, form of fashion gave them consent to do that. So what we gotta do is find out, go back in time to try to retrieve where did I actually get the permission to be able to call you right now?
At the mall. When I signed up for a car.
What is that? That's the contract. You went at the dealership to get a car. Okay, yeah, but realize the contract involved when you get the car, some of the small print. What else would you give them permission to do? Outside of just them giving you the keys to the car. I just went to the chiropractor the other day. This is my back cracks. But I look at a privacy notice and it says at the top, this application gives us permission to share your information and data to all these different offices. What authority, laws of law enforcement, whatever, it's very, like, the stuff that people don't even read. You know what I'm saying? So it's like, so, and this stuff is high tech, and I don't know how far where other people go to. So, like, they got this high tech stuff. I'm talking about foot scans, digital this, digital that. And see, we can track to what technology and convenience. But we gotta take time to stop it. But what else are we signing up for? Every time we download that app on our phone. What is the inside of that display? How many of you actually read the display before you sign up for Facebook? That got pretty good. I can't remember it. But I'm not saying that we should actually have time to read all of this and print it out. That's not realistic. What I'm saying is know how to deserve the rights in the contract and know you get into the contract. And have said, like, bro, we don't call it this. We got our flip phones. You know, we don't play around. You know what I'm saying? Like we gotta separate that from our true lives. You know, we go out to the matrix world to conduct our commerce and business, but you gotta know how to get back to that pig farm so Morgan can tap back to Zion where we'll be good and safe. You know what I'm saying? We gotta take the opposite to lose the world and accomplish these lucrative accomplishments, thinking that's it. We good, we safe. We got a lot of work to do. We're far behind schedule because not because we put ourselves there, we've been pushed behind schedule. So we gotta get snapped out of this reality that we have. And utilize the people that we have, the resources that we have to do what we gotta do to make our money, but now we get back to the root causes of the issue. Because no matter how much money we got, this doesn't stop the issues that people are dealing with. We hear it all the time on the news. All the time. So it don't matter how much money. How much of your time is yours? How many people have all their own time? I own my time. Bro say, I need you to raise your fish fire. I'm here. I'm not looking on schedule. I make the schedule. That's it. So killing the concept of time is half the battle. Oh, I gotta get those ready to go. No, I'm not doing all that. I get up when I please. I'm sure why I want to be at period. Because I say so. But we all say so. It's all about just saying stop. No, if this is what I'm doing today, this is what I'm not doing today. If you don't like it, it's the art of saying, fuck you, fuck it. Probably would have liked a better term. Fuck it. Because that's the stuff that wants you to stress out and be all depressed, anxiety, wants you to result to the near drug and alcohol outside of leisure.
And hospitals.
There's the hospitals, you know, they need to be addiction. You know, we got to pay attention to everything we're doing. From the day of birth, we signed up for this shit. From the day of birth, and it continues. We have to claim ownership over ourselves and over our families and our children. If not, somebody else will. And who is that somebody else?
Probate office.
It's called the state insurance. Whatever's on your driver's license, that's who custody that you're in. But we all just know. A non-digit number for the most part that ensures the contract that you signed for the one called birth certificate. How many people stopped the doctor when she was getting the finger press down to the foot press down to the baby when the baby was born? Not knowing that they're putting that baby as a contract by because identification is by your finger press and your foot press. It's a contract right there, the application. All the babies are worse than the word to say. I'm not even claiming we're not like. Simple as that. But we so caught up in the moment. I'm not even caught up in the moment, caught up in the hype. Like, oh my God, look at him, he's the door. No. I know he is. But what's that paperwork there? Snap, snap, snap. I'll take that back to the laboratory. I'm not playing this game. Because we can't not acknowledge these things and be unconscious of the fact of the matter. And then everybody comes like, oh my God, why are you doing this? This is the right. You got to pay attention to where it's up here.
But my name is Joseph Dean, but everybody knows me as the Wolf of Chicago. So I already call me Wolf, not Joseph. We're just in a transparent situation. You can know my real name. I'm the founder of the association. love Shine Eye Promotions Marketing and Media Company. We specialize in websites, commercials, photography, videography, logo design, brochures, and pretty much everything. I have all things information when it comes to knowing what's going on in Chicago, when it comes to social rights, and when it comes to people who are trying to get their foot in the door. People, I arrange business relationships. I arrange for people to know who's doing what and who's not doing what. Shout out to all the associates that's in the building. Raise your hand. We are looking to recruit new members. What is the association? It's a Black Business Investment Group. We, as business owners, we come together to find ways to bring awareness to our individual businesses. What that means, we do particular projects, charitable events, we do big events, we do mixers. We are on our 13th event. We do events like Hoverboard Fashion Show, Masquerade Balls, Pin-Up Balls, Black Tie Events. And every event we do, we put a theme next to it. Why do we put a theme on everything we do? Because what we all do for a living, is work to the average person. They only want the services when they need it. So we find ways to get them to act impulsively on getting the service. That's why we came up with a Hoverboard Fashion Show. People want to come to see the Hoverboard Fashion Show because they want to see what the models fall onto other buildings. So now, when we do these events, and we make this money, of course, money is part of us as well. We make this money, we give it all. Now we're going to be marketing what we do. Everybody's coming on stage, swag bags, business cards being passed around. They're going to know what you do before they leave that building. So it's kind of like a camouflage. And that's what we do as an association. To be an association, of course, you have to come to one of our events, which is the mandatory events, so that's the same one. You have to be on at least 3 to 5 social media outlets. You must be willing to invest. You must sit down with me before I can do a psych evaluation. Now, I'm not a psych or anything like that, but I know good people. And I know people who are driven, who are motivated, who want to get something done. So that right there is what would be the hardest part. Sit down with me, we talk, and I see where your head is. If you're going to be somebody that's going to go far in your business, it's when we actually, all of us in here, are living testament. Because when these people first came into the association, I can get them some photo shoots, I can get them the meetings, they show up on time for events. Nope, can't do that now. They are established, got the business is flourishing. We got big things going on. I gotta keep rescheduling photo shoots because I can't get 5 of them up because they're busy, they book, and that's what it's all about. And I'm not upset about that. I love it. But I think he has a culture. Because that's a requirement. You must do photo shoots and video shoots so they are able to advertise you. Yeah. So yeah, I'll come back in 9 minutes. Thank you.